गुड आफ्टरनून डियर स्टूडेंट्स. इन माई करंट वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस विद यू द हॉल इफेक्ट. दिस टॉपिक बिलोंग्स टू योर सेक्शन बी ऑफ पेपर सी. दिस हॉल इफेक्ट वॉज गिवन बाई एन अमेरिकन फिजिकिस्ट E.H. हॉल इन 1870 एंड ही शोड इन हिज एक्सपेरिमेंट दैट वेन एवर ए कंडक्टर, तो कंडक्टर हेयर में बी ए प्लेट और यू कैन से अ सेमी कंडक्टर कैरिंग अ करंट is placed in transverse magnetic field. Here the word transverse magnetic field means the magnetic field which is perpendicular to the current. In such a conductor, an electric field is automatically set up in the conductor in a direction perpendicular to both the current and the magnetic field, which is known as Hall field, and this phenomena is known as Hall effect. So Hall effect helps us to know about the type, or you can say nature of the charge carriers in a conductor, that whether the charge carriers are the positive charge carriers or the negative charge carriers. So before starting to drive the expression, I'll show you somewhere here the diagram. See what I have taken in the diagram. There is a metallic rectangular strip I have taken whose bottom face is O A F G and the upper face is B C D dash E. Here I have taken the point as D dash because D is the distance between the upper face and the lower face. I have shown over here that a current I, see, it is a current I which is flowing through this metallic strip along the positive x-axis. So although I have not shown the source of this current, but still the current I is flowing through the positive x-axis and magnetic field is applied along the positive z-axis. See, I have shown over here. Now, if I connect a voltmeter along the between the upper face and the lower face by this wires, this voltmeter will show a reading which simply indicates that the electric field has been set up, or you can say a potential difference has been set up between the upper face and the lower face of this metallic strip. So what is the origin of this Hall, this potential difference, or you can say this Hall field, electric field? This is the main purpose of this experiment. For this purpose, I want to draw your attention that consider a metallic rectangular strip O A B C D dash E F G carrying a current I along the positive x-axis as shown in figure A. Let a magnetic field B vector is applied along positive x-axis. That is, I can write B vector equal to B into cap. Name this as equation number 1. Now I will discuss the two types of charge carriers. First taken, the case is taken as for the negative charge carriers. It means simply if this metallic strip is consisted of the negative charge carriers, means the majority charge carrier are the negative charge carriers, then what happens? See, if the current is flowing along positive x-axis, we all know that current I is simply the rate of flow of positive charge. It means positive charge is flowing towards the positive x-axis. So in that way, negative charges are flowing towards the negative x-axis. So what is V here? It is the drift velocity of the negative charges which is taken along negative x-axis, and magnetic field is taken along the positive z-axis. Alright, now if I apply the right hand thumb rule on V cross B, this will simply give me a magnetic force Fm, which I'll explain here. Now see, let a metallic strip contains negative charged particles as charge carriers. Since electric current I is along positive x-axis, which is the rate of flow of positive charge, so it means negative charged particles will drift with the velocity V vector along the negative x-axis. So I can write velocity vector as V vector is equal to minus V into I cap. So what is the force, magnetic force on the positive negative charged particle? It is simply given by, you might have done this expression in your 10 plus 2 class, that if a charged particle is moving with the velocity V in the magnetic field, the magnetic force experienced by the charged particle is simply given by this expression E into V cross B. Since I have taken the negative charges, so I have taken as minus E into V cross B. So V simply means minus V I cap. B simply means B K cap. I will put these two values here in this equation, and on solving, I will simply get F M is minus of minus positive. It is E V B into I cap cross K cap. So what is your I cap cross K cap? It is minus J cap. So I'll get equation number 4. This equation simply means that this magnetic force on the negative charge is in minus J cap direction. Means along the negative y-axis in the downward direction. So as a result of Fm in equation number 4, the negative charges will experience a net force in the downward direction, that is along negative y-axis, and start to accumulate on the face OAFD, the bottom face OAFD. Negative charge will start to accumulate over here. Now, consequently, so as a result of this, an equal amount of positive charge will appear on the opposite face BCDE. This opposite face BCDE. Exactly equal amount of negative, which is equal to the positive charge, will accumulate on the opposite face. Now, due to which, so this face becomes a positive and this face becomes a negative. That is why the potential difference has been set up between these two faces. So, due to which, an electric field, or you can say potential difference, is set up, which is known as Hall field. Electric field EH, which is known as Hall field, will set up along the negative y-axis. Now students, electric field is always directed from positive plate towards the negative plate. This simply means electric field is directed along the negative y-axis. So I can write EH vector is minus EH into J cap. So in equilibrium means over here that when a sufficient amount of negative charges have been accumulated on the lower face, the flow of the charges will stop. In that case, the equilibrium has been set up. This simply means the net electric force plus magnetic force on the charged particle becomes zero. So in this way, Fe vector is equal to minus of Fm. So what is Fe? It is charge into electric field, means minus E into EH vector. And what is magnetic force? It is simply given by this equation number 4. So I'll be using these two equations over here. I'll get this equation. Minus E goes on cancelled. EH vector can be put as minus EH into J cap. So on solving this equation, I'll get equation number 7. So if V is a constant, see drift velocity of the electrons in the or the negative charge particle is taken as a constant. So EH is proportional to B, or simply you can say that the Hall voltage developed in the strip will be directly proportional to the strength of the applied magnetic field. Now let us take the case of positive charge carry. Means what happens if this negative charge would have been a positive charge? In that case, the rate of flow of positive charge is taken as the current, and the current is along x-axis. It means positive charges will drift velocity v vector along the positive x-axis. It means I can write v vector is equal to v into I cap. And what will be the magnetic force? It is plus E, because here I have taken the positive charge. So E into V cross B. So putting the value of V is equal to V into I cap, B is equal to B into K cap, I'll get the next equation, which is simply giving me the magnetic force on the charged particle. So see, you can see over here that again I cap cross K cap comes out to be minus J cap. The magnetic force comes out to be minus E V B into J cap. That means the positive charges again will experience a downwards force. That means all the positive charges will be accumulated on the downward face, that is OAFG of the strip. So as a result of which, an equal amount of negative charges will be now developed on the upper face, means on the top face BC D dash E. All right, now it means the Hall field will be set up in the string now, which will be along positive y-axis, because electric field is always from positive plate towards the negative plate. Now my bottom plate is positive and the upper plate is negative, so electric field will be directly directed from the positive J cap. That is EH vector can be written as EH into J cap. Now this equation 11 shows that Hall field is in direction which is opposite to that of the equation number 5, EH vector is equal to minus EH J cap, which was in the case of negative charged particles. Hence, the direction of Hall field is an indication of the type of charge carriers responsible for the current that in the conductor. That means if the charge carriers are positive, you will get an electric field or Hall field directed in the positive y direction. And if the charge carriers are negative, you will get an electric field or Hall field directed in the negative y-axis. Now let us draw an expression for the Hall voltage. What is the meaning of Hall voltage over here? I have connected already a voltmeter between the top face and the upper face of the diagram. That voltmeter V, it will show me that there is a voltage set up in the two faces, which is known to be Hall voltage, and it is represented by VH. D is the distance between the upper face and the lower faces. Then simply I can write EH is equal to VH upon D. How this expression comes out to be?
Students, you might be knowing that electric field is always the gradient of electric potential. That means electric potential divided by the distance. It comes out to be the electric field. We all know this very well. This is the expression which has been taken from your 10 plus 2 class. So now I can use the value of EH as VB, which is equal to VH upon D. So from here I can write V is equal to VH upon BD. So this simply means the expression for the drift velocity of the charge carriers in terms of Hall voltage. So you can see here that drift velocity is inversely proportional to the strength of the magnetic field. Now let us derive an expression for Hall constant, or you can say it is Hall coefficient. This is very important, students. Now we know that the current density J of the conductors having charge carriers Q is related to the drift velocity V as J is equal to NQV. Student, this is the relation which we have already derived in your first semester, that is the drift velocity, the relation with respect to the current density J. So from here I can write V is equal to J upon NQ. Name this as equation number 14. So in equation 14, I am going to use the equation number 7. What is the equation number 7? It was 7th equation. I will just show you the 7th equation. The 7th equation is this one. EH is equal to VB. So I'll be using this equation, VB is equal to EH in here. I'll get EH is equal to JB upon NQ. So taking the value of EH as V into B. V means J upon NQ. B means already is there. So from here, you can take this equation in this form. Equation number 15. In equation number 15, the quantity 1 upon NQ, which is appeared on the right hand side, it is simply known as Hall constant or Hall coefficient and is denoted by RH. So RH means 1 upon NQ, which is equal to EH upon JB. This is the expression of Hall coefficient, or you can say Hall constant. Students, this is an expression which is very important in this article, because this is going to tell you about the charge carriers, that whether the charge carriers are positive or the negative charge carriers. If you will get RH as a negative, then it must mean that Q is negative. That means the charge carriers are negative. If you are getting an expression RH as positive, that means the Q is positive. It means all the charge carriers in the conductor are positive charge carriers. Thus, Q is positive, RH will be positive, and Q is negative, RH will be negative. This is all about the Hall constant or Hall coefficient. Now let us talk of the uses of this Hall effect, where we can use the Hall effect, or you can say the applications of Hall effect. So Hall effect is used for the two purposes. First, determination for the carrier concentration. My dear students, from here you can find out N directly if you know EH, J and B. Now determination of type of semiconductor, whether it is a P-type semiconductor or N-type semiconductor, means if there is a P-type semiconductor, Q must be positive, and if there must be a negative Q if there is an N-type charge carriers. This is all about the Hall effect, which is going to be a very important topic for exam point of view. Thank you so much.